Today's lecture is going to cover contrast. The definition of contrast is the difference between adjacent shades of gray on a radiographic image. With digital systems, it is known as the dynamic range, and it is controlled by the window width function. KVP is the primary controller of contrast. It is responsible for variations in the shades of gray due to varying energy levels in the primary beam. Low KVP creates high contrast images that are primarily black and white. High KVP creates low contrast images that have many shades of gray. Increasing contrast is similar to saying fewer shades of gray, less scatter, and decreasing KVP and less latitude. Low contrast provides more information because there are more differences in density provided. High contrast is typically preferred when discussing fog and scatter because the least amount of fog and scatter is always desired. Contrast is needed because without the differences in shades of gray, all densities would appear identical. The scale of contrast is the number of useful shades of gray. Low KVP creates short scale, high contrast, black and white images. High KVP creates long scale, low contrast images with many shades of gray. When discussing contrast in terms of scatter fog, high contrast is preferred because we always want to minimize scatter. When discussing scale of contrast, the preference is based upon what anatomy or pathology is desired. For example, high contrast short scale is preferred for extremities and skeletal imaging. Low contrast long scale is preferred for chest imaging. Physical contrast is the total range of density or IR exposure values that are recorded by the image receptor. It is the maximum contrast possible and the most accurate representation of the varying intensities in the beam after interaction with the patient. Visible contrast is the total range of density or IR exposure values that can be perceived by the human eye for each radiographic image. Manipulation of contrast is usually made with adjustments in KVP or by adjusting the window width. Image contrast is the total amount of contrast that is acquired from the image receptor and the part being imaged. These are separately known as image receptor contrast and subject contrast. To adjust the contrast on a digital image, the window width must be manipulated. The algorithm applied to the image will provide the proper grayscale regardless of variations in mass and KVP. Extremities will have higher short scale contrast, and chest exams will have longer low scale contrast. Subject contrast is the range of differences in beam intensity after interacting with the part or patient. It is dependent upon KVP, the amount of irradiated material, and the type of irradiated material. KVP is the primary control of contrast and subject contrast. As KVP increases, a wider latitude of photon energies is created, which leads to a wider latitude of densities on the image. KVP also controls the penetrating power of the beam. For high contrast, low KVP is preferred. For low contrast, high KVP is preferred. Contrast is also dependent upon the thickness of the part, field size, and pathology. The thicker the part, the greater the field size, the presence of pathology, all affect attenuation and scatter. Any factor that increases fog or scatter decreases contrast. Contrast is also dependent upon the atomic number and density of the tissue. Materials with higher atomic number, such as bone, absorb more of the primary beam. Materials with lower atomic number, such as air, allow the primary beam to pass through with little absorption. High KVP, low mass techniques reduce patient dose. High KVP decreases contrast because of the increased amount of fog and scatter. There is a range of KVP values which are appropriate to obtain sufficient subject contrast without creating excessive scatter in patient dose. A visible change in contrast will not be seen unless KVP is changed by 4 to 12%. Typically, lower KVP will provide higher contrast. However, if KVP is too low, the penetrating power of the beam is affected. This is greatly important in exams such as the spine, abdomen, or pelvis. Compton interactions affect contrast because they increase the amount of scatter, and these interactions increase as KVP is increased. With the photoelectric effect, low KVP allows for more of the low energy photons to be absorbed and provides higher contrast. KVP is the primary controlling factor of contrast, and there are several other influencing factors, such as mass, SID, filtration, beam restriction, anatomical part, grid, and the image receptor. Mass influences contrast because contrast is decreased if the image is over or under exposed. The intensity of the beam changes as SID changes. The intensity or energy contributes to contrast. Scatter is reduced as OID is increased, and contrast increases as scatter decreases. This is the concept behind the air gap technique. Filtration increases the average energy of the beam by absorbing the low energy photons. Beam intensity is decreased as some of the primary beam is also absorbed. The increase in beam energy causes an increase in scatter. Decreased intensity decreases density and contrast. Restriction of the beam reduces the number of photons reaching the image receptor. The amount of scatter is reduced, so contrast is increased. The patient is the prime attenuator of the X-ray beam. As part thickness increases, the amount of scatter increases and contrast decreases. As tissue density increases, scatter also increases and contrast decreases. Higher grid ratios allow for greater scatter cleanup and greater contrast. Contrast is lower when a film is exposed to X-rays only than when exposed to light, such as when using intensifying screens. For digital images, contrast can be manipulated with post-processing. Some exams utilize contrast agents instead of technical factors to increase contrast. Examples include an upper GI, a BE, also known as a lower GI, and an IVP. The contrast agents are utilized to increase contrast in the area of interest. Here are some examples of images using contrast media. In summary, the two types of contrast include scatter fog and scale of contrast. Be sure to keep them separated. The type of contrast being discussed will always be described on quizzes and tests.